Welcome guys, this is Saul Amit from Coding is Easy. In this tutorial or in this video, what we are gonna see is how to create a sign up page using React frontend and Nest.js backend, which is basically a TypeScript backend framework. Before that, we have to check whether we have installed Node.js in your computer or not. So for checking Node.js, just say Node version. If you haven't installed Node.js, then go ahead and install Node.js. After that, check whether you have installed Nest.js in your computer or not. For checking Nest.js, you have to say just Nest version. Yes, here you can see we also have installed Nest.js in your computer. If you haven't installed both of these two, just go and install. After that, come and watch this tutorial. Okay guys, let's create a folder. Let's say make dir sign up. Okay, after that we have to get into signups. After that we have to create two folders, one is for frontend and another one is for backend. Let's say cd. First we have to create a folder for frontend, make dir frontend, then create another one folder for backend. Let's say make dir backend. Okay, after that get into the frontend directory, cd frontend. Now we have to create a React app. Creating a React app is very simple. Just say npx create React app, give it a name. I'm gonna say sign up client. Oh, sorry for the misspell. Then it begins to installation. After that, open another tab in the terminal and get out of from the front end directory and get into the back end directory. For creating a nest app is damn simple. Just say nest new sign up, what can I say, back end. Okay, Nest will ask you whether you are go with npm or run. Let's choose npm. If you are preferring yarn, you can go with yarn, but I am going with npm. See, our front end React is installing and our backend is installing. You don't want to worry about the boilerplate. Both React and Nest.js give you a boilerplate. This video I only focus on front end, and I will create a separate video, and let's say part 2 video for this. Then there we will discuss the backend part, like dealing with Nest.js, how to create REST APIs. For this we are gonna deal with React, creating a simple sign up page. Here you can see guys, our backend Nest.js is installed, but still our React is not installed. It does take a time to install React, but our backend is ready. We can go through our backend files. Let's see, let's get out of from the backend directory, and we can see our backend and frontend both is inside the sign up directory. We can get into our favorite code editor, which is Visual Studio Code. We can go through the files in the Nest.js. Here you can see there are many files in the sign up backend. First of all, node models, which you guys are very familiar with this, and this is a test folder which you are not gonna discuss about it, and our main folder, which is source. Here you can see the main.ts file. Here you can see the main.ts file, which is the main file which initialize the app. Here you can see a function which is bootstrap, which is basically initializing the app. Here we have to change the port number because our React app gonna run on port number 3000, so that's why I'm gonna change it to 8000. This is the main file which initialize the app, and after that we have app.module.ts, the second main file. Here you can see we have imported modules from Nest.js and app controller, which is basically a module, and we have our providers and controllers, and we are going to the third most important file, which is controller. Controller file is basically handles the GET request, or whether it is a POST request or it is a DELETE request, whatever the request. And our main file is service.ts, which is the very important file, which because we are gonna write our logic in this file. Here you can see a method which is called get hello. It just returns a string. And in the controller, you can see we have imported our app service, and we are using the same app service dot get hello method, which is basically a get request, and it returns hello world. Nothing much more, and we are not gonna do anything in this video with this. We are just going to go down our front end, which is basically React. It is still downloading. I don't know why it is taking that much time. Okay, before that we can run our Nest.js file. For running our Nest.js, first we have to get into our backend. After that backend, Nest.js project, which is sign up backend. For running Nest.js, you have to say npm run start, or even you can say nest start, or you can say npm run start in dev mode. Here you can see our front end React is installed. Our backend app is started. Yes, here you can see our Nest.js backend app is ready. 1000 port. Here you can see hello world. Yes, we are done with our backend. We are not gonna do anything for now because we are gonna see backend port in the next video. Okay, let's open our source file, which you guys are very familiar with React. So this way I'm not gonna waste my time by explaining any React files. Let's say hello world. Control plus save. Let's open another one tab in this terminal and get into our front end and our React app. Now let's run our React app. I think we are very familiar with running React, so let's just say npm run start. It's saying starting the development server. Yes, we get our React app, which is running on port number 3000. We are very good to go. Okay, let's go to the app.js file and edit and do some HTMLs. Let's say sign up. It's changes. Let's create a form. Okay, input field. Sorry guys. Okay, let's say it is required. and type is text, and it's a value is equal to, let's say, username. Let's do this p username, and an important function which is on change. If user writes something on our input field, it is changing, so that's why we are using on change function. On change is equal to, let's create a function here. It does take a event and it just sets into, oh, before that, let me create a const username. Basically, I am creating a use state. It does take a variable and a function. Let's say a variable username, and the function name is set username. Basically, you guys are very familiar with this, so that's why I don't want to explain it that much. Let's do a magic here. Use state and hit enter. You can just listen on the number one. Ta-da! Basically, what it does is Visual Studio automatically imported it. I didn't do anything, it's Visual Studio's magic. Let's keep it an empty string. When user writes on our input field, it has to change our username. Set username is equal to whatever the user writes, e.target.value. Okay, let's copy this. Okay, before that, I wanna create a email field. Email, set email. It is also a use state. You guys have already guessed it. Yes, it's correct. Control Z. Let's paste this. Let's change this username to email, and its type should be email, and here username has to be changed to email, and set username is gonna be set email. Okay, let's go up with our password. For that, I have to say const password. Sorry. Set. It is also a use state. Okay, let's paste it another one time. And say username is gonna be password. Yes, you guys have guessed it right. PSWOT. Change the P to caps. It doesn't matter. And our username has to be password. Yes, we have to change this one also. Team. And we have to place it a button here, right? Let's say submit. Type is gonna be submit. CUP. Okay, let's go and see. Yes, it's everything is correct. Let's make it bolder, the sign up. Which one? Here you can see our sign up is little bit bolder because we have used H1 there. Okay, I think we are done with this. Let's do our logic. Here you have to, in the form you have to handle the submit basically. Let's say on submit, whenever the user clicks the submit button, we have to run a function. Let's say handle submit. Okay guys, now we have to create our handle submit function. Let's say const handle submit is equal to an arrow function. It does take an even, so that's why we can able to prevent the default behavior of the browser, e.prevent. Prevent default, oh sorry guys. F-A-U-E-L-T. After that we can able to access our username, email and password, so that's why we can just console it. Console.log username, then email, after that password. Okay, we can run our front end React.js. Let's get into our front end folder. After that React project, and then say npm run start. Here you can see our front end app is ready. Okay, let's open our browser console, enter Control Shift I. Okay, let's write our username, which is Ahul or whatever you want, and write our email.com. Password say 123 Sahul and hit submit. You will get username and email and password on your console. If you didn't get, you have done a mistake. As you can see, we can get our username, password and email. Okay, let's do our operation. First, we have to install a library called Axios. So get into front end directory and React project and say npm I Axios. Okay, we installed our Axios library, and we have to basically, what is Axios is a HTTP client for basically we are dealing with REST API, like fetching data and sending data to backend. So that's why we are gonna use Axios, or others you can use fetch, but Axios is much better. Okay, let's say Axios. Okay guys, first of all we have to import Axios. Let's say import Axios from Axios. Okay, we successfully imported Axios. We have to work with it. Let's say Axios dot post. And our URL, you can see here, it is asking a URL and the data, which of the data has to be posted. Our URL is http://localhost, sorry guys, it's i1000, you guys are remember I think. Okay, we have to send, what are the data we have to send. Let's say username, which is in our case is also username. After that an email, which in our case also email. After that we have to send our password, which in our case also password. Okay, Axios is basically it returns a promise, so we have to put a then and catch. Let's say then it gives a successful response if it gets succeed. let's say response. We are not gonna do very much with it, just we are consoling it, nothing more than that. Console response. Otherwise, if we get any error, we have to catch it in the catch block. Let's say it gives an error. We are not gonna do anything much for now, and just say console.log. Let's get out of from this view. Okay, we can see Saul at mail@gmail.com, whatever, and password 123 Saul. Let's say submit. Here you can see an error which is basically saying a cross policy error, which is a backend error which we are not gonna deal in this video. We are going to deal in another video, which is part 2. Until then, share this video, like this video, and comment. Thank you guys.